Here with Precision CrossFit and Battle of the Boxes. I have some spare time and I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna go over the workouts right now, give you guys a quick briefing, and you can watch this video, and then tomorrow we'll do the briefing again and maybe there'll be less questions. So starting with WOD 1, we got a 17 minute cap, 4 time, 4,500 meter row. While that's happening, the other three athletes will complete 300 double unders, 75 thrusters, 75 hang snatch, 75 shoulder overhead, 300 double unders, 75 toes to bar, one person working at a time. Now guys, understand this. This is a regional setup. So you'll have your rower set up at the top of the lane. And then throughout the lane, there'll be various quadrants. As you are done with the movements, you will move into the next quadrant, 300 double unders. Next quadrant with the barbell, 75 thrusters. Move that barbell forward to the next quadrant, 75 snatches. Move that barbell forward to the next quadrant, 75 shoulder overhead. Move your jump ropes forward to the next quadrant, 300 double unders. Then you'll be in front of the rig. You'll do your 75 toes to bar. When everybody's done, there'll be a start end mat underneath the rig. Everyone must be on that start end mat for the clock to stop. Now, you'll probably have someone rowing still. Yes, I know you'll have somebody rowing still. I've done this workout. They'll be at the beginning of the top of the lane still. You're gonna have to wait or help them, however you need to get that done. When everybody's done, you all must be under the start end mat. Being under the start end mat constitutes as 1 point. That's WOD 1. I'm sure there'll be questions and we'll go over that. WOD 2, the men will go first. They will run down the lane. Intermediate teams will do 50 pull-ups however they want between the two men. Then they will do 50 synchronized burpees. Your chests must touch the bar, must touch the ground at the same time. That's all that's required. Then you'll work through 30 hang cleans. Every single 10 reps, you will move the bar forward to, yes, another quadrant. 10 reps, move the bar forward, 10 reps, move the bar forward, 10 reps. If you're the man, you're tagging the women. Advanced, same exact thing, but you have 50 synchronized chest to bar pull-ups next to each other. All that's required is both your chests touch the bar at the same time. Okay, same thing, 50 synchronized burpees, chest touching the butt ground, 10 reps, 10 reps, 10 reps, start end mat. Tag the partners, you're moving. Now, when you get down to that lane, there'll be two barbells in front of the bars. For the men especially, you have to roll that barbell out for your burpees. The women's barbell will remain there. Both barbells will obviously end by the start end mats when it's over. Women will go down, same thing as the men, 50 pull-ups or synchronized chest to bar, 50 bar facing burpees, 10, I'm doing this one take, guys, 10 cleans till the end, start end mat, when everyone's on the clock, time, it's one score, it's combined time, okay? From there, the floater, we can kind of pan out. I'm actually in the floater pit right now. You got those badass rogue prowlers. You got a lane going down, 30 and 20. Okay, so it's just pain. You're gonna do 20 front squats. Pick your order however you want. There will be, ready, 4 plates for the advanced men and 3 plates for the advanced women. Meaning you must take a plate off for the women and put a plate on for the men, however you want. It's follow the leader format. You'll do 20 front squats, you'll push that prowler. While that prowler's in play, yes, somebody else can be doing their front squats, but you cannot move on to a portion of the workout without completing the first portion. You can't have multiple people do front squats and waiting for the prowler. It doesn't work that way. You will stay at your spot until that other portion's done, then you'll walk to it. Okay, we'll go over that more in depth tomorrow. For intermediate, 3 plates for the men, 2 plates for the women. Okay, you'll do your 20 front squats, you'll push it 30 yards down, past the line, turn it around, 30 yards back. 20 yards down, past the line, turn it around, 20 yards back, next partner will go. Okay, one thing I did not mention for the first workout, I wanna go back to, 4,500 meter row. Nobody has to stop working. If someone's not rowing, you can keep doing the chipper. That's fine, but you won't ever wanna stop rowing. So people are asking that question, can you stop rowing? No, you can, but that's on you. Okay? See you tomorrow morning, bright and early.